Michael Jackson at age 11 was the youngest vocalist ever to top the Hot 100. Platin was 34 years old when she released her Fight Song EP. This is my fight song. Take back my life song. It's an amazing song. Welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joel from Running Official, and it's time for our daily ritual, guys. Let's just sacrifice this goat to the bigger goat. Okay, so now that's done, let's look into an interesting music topic. We have singers who got famous young versus late in life. Young people in this video will be 16 years old or younger, and old in this video will be 30 years old or older. Let's get started. Got famous early, Billie Eilish, age 14. She looks young here. She had that presence already at 14. That is crazy. I don't think I could do a stare like that. Is her hand dirty? She sounds great. Such a good song. That's so pretty. That vocal is amazing. Okay, so let's look into how Billie Eilish blew up so early. On November 18, 2015, Eilish recorded the song Ocean Eyes. The track was written, mixed, and produced by Eilish's brother, Phineas. Phineas had written and produced Ocean Eyes originally for his band, The Slightlys, before realizing it would be a better fit for Eilish's vocals. A music video for Ocean Eyes was directed by Megan Thompson and was uploaded to Eilish's official YouTube channel on March 24, 2016. Ocean Eyes and Eilish received praise and promotion from various social media outlets and marketers, including radio stations and music supervisors such as Beats One, KCRW, BBC One, Zane Lowe, Jason Kramer, Animac, and Chris Doritos. Phineas' manager had reached out to him after he made Ocean Eyes to discuss Eilish's potential. In a deal arranged by Phineas, Apple Music signed Eilish to A&R company Platoon, which helps package artists before they get a major label deal. Eilish then got a publicist who connected her to the luxury fashion brand Chanel, and a stylist, both of whom helped shape her image. This is much more corporate than I thought. I just thought that they basically came out of the bedroom. Super interesting. And here we have someone who got famous late, Susan Boyle, at age 47. Gotta love this. I dreamed a dream in time gone by.
You didn't expect that, did you?
Classic clip. When Susan Boyle confounded the expectations of a sniggering audience and snarky judges on Britain's Got Talent 2009, she proved that it's never too late to find your true calling. It was obvious that Boyle hadn't had the easiest of lives. Misdiagnosed with a learning disability in childhood, she only found out in 2013, aged 52, that she actually had Asperger's syndrome with an above-average IQ. Boyle had spent years trying to win the attention of the music industry, entering contests and appearing on Barrymore's My Kind of People, but she never gave up. Within 9 days of going on Britain's Got Talent, her audition clip had been viewed more than 100 million times. That's crazy. However, we didn't really see that much from Susan after this, right? Too bad. Next up, we have someone who got famous early, Stevie Wonder, and he became big at age 12, but became even more famous at age 13. He could already play the harmonica really well. Imagine how much pressure to be sold as the 12-year-old genius. That's so dope. So let's have a look at how he got famous. Born Steveland Hardway Judkins, he had performed as a child in the choir at the Whitestone Baptist Church in his hometown of Saginaw, Michigan, along with his mother and siblings. By the tender age of 10, the boy Wonder could sing and play piano and drums. He was snapped up by Motown Records a year later. Hearing him messing around on instruments in the studio, Motown boss Berry Gordy Jr. marveled out loud that this boy was a wonder. The name stuck. Okay. On 10th of August, aged just 13 years and 189 days, he scored a US Billboard Hot 100 number one single with the Infectious Fingertips Part 2, showcasing his snappy harmonica style. Okay, so that was what we just listened to. Billboard number one at 13 years old. That's so dope, man. Then we got famous late Rachel Platten at age 34. Still love this song so much. This has been used for political purposes too much, so it's a little bit tainted, but still, it's an amazing song. That's awesome. Those lyrics and those melodies are just incredible. So how did this happen? Platten was 34 years old when she released her Fight Song EP, which delivered the breakout's top 10 single of the same name. The 2015 track has been certified double platinum by the Recording Industry Association of America. It's also become a popular song for media usage, getting featured in shows like Pretty Little Liars and Supergirl, as well as in commercials for Ford.
Yay, Ford!
It was also used as an anthem for Hillary Clinton's presidential campaign. I wonder if that might actually work against her since Hillary lost. Platten's subsequent full-length release, Wildflower, was released in 2016 and reached number 5 on the Billboard 200. I think she's still considered a one-hit wonder to some extent. I think that's gonna be a trend a little bit with the people who do blow up late, that they will have like one song and then maybe labels and stuff won't have the confidence to want to invest in them because there's not that many years left for them to be monetized. Like, when will you lose your appeal? Okay, so Britney Spears got famous early, age 16. This is so classic, it's hard to listen to it normally. I love the chords and everything. When I'm not with you, I lose my mind. Give me a sign. I mean, this is really impressive. She also has the whole like Billie Eilish stage presence and, you know, even more because she's also dancing really well. So how, you're asking, did Britney blow up? Britney showed interest in the performing arts from a young age and competed in several talent shows and commercials. At age 11, she was cast in The Mickey Mouse Club alongside Christina Aguilera, Ryan Gosling, and Justin Timberlake. The Mickey Mouse Club at that time was kind of Disney's way to train artists and train people to become big under the Disney brand. After The Mickey Mouse Club was canceled, she eventually got the attention of Jive Records, who, after hearing Britney Spears sing in front of the executives, ordered a full album and set her up to work with Sharon Studios in Stockholm, Sweden. Early Max Martin. Her debut studio album, Dot 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 Baby One More Time, was released on January 12, 1999. It debuted at number one on the US Billboard 200 and was certified 2x platinum by the Recording Industry Association of America after a month. Worldwide, the album topped the charts in 15 countries and sold over 10 million copies in a year. That's a lot of copies. It became the biggest selling album ever by a teenage artist. Do you guys hear that? Is that a tuba? This video has been sponsored by Wondershare. Wondershare is a very handsome company that makes simple and easy to use products. They have 65 products in over 150 countries. One of the highlights to me is their video editing program, Filmora, a modern, user-friendly video editor. Have you ever heard of those? Filmora has tons of effects and more are being added continuously. One awesome feature I really like is beat detection. Basically, Filmora detects the beats so you can edit easily to music without like scrubbing around and trying to find like where to cut to be on beat. God, that's something I've always wanted. So thank you, Filmora.
This is gonna save so much time.
Filmora also has a super convenient split screen tools that can do stuff like this.
Split screen.
That was it, huh? No, Wondershare makes a lot of other really convenient products like Uniconverter that easily converts your media files into over 1,000 different media formats. Or how about FilmStock, your one-stop shop for motion packs and stock media. Easy. As my beloved big booty viewers, you can get Wondershare products at a discount. They've even told me it's a better deal than Black Friday. What? So click the link in the description right now. For example, a Filmora perpetual license, that means forever, usually costs $79.99. But now with my link, you can get Filmora and FilmStock at $59.99. What a deal! Ah, what a deal! Again, click the link in the description to check it out. Thanks to Wondershare for sponsoring this video. Okay, so Guts famous late 2 Chainz, age 34. Smoking on that gas. Life should be on Cinemax. Movie. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know a lot about 2 Chainz. Who he's not, I smoke strong, not pie pie. He seems to be wearing 2 Chainz. Actually, hey, should be called 4 Chainz. Oh, this is interesting. So, a name change can make all the difference. Just ask 2 Chainz. The rapper worked for years under the name T.I.T.Y. Boy. I'm not gonna say that. I'm not gonna get demonetized for this. He decided to change it to a more family-friendly moniker in 2011, and apparently it worked. Shortly after, he released his 7th mixtape, True Religion. Very punny. And it became his first work to make it onto the Billboard charts. He was 34 at the time. He has since collaborated with some of the most famous names in music, like Kanye West and Nicki Minaj, and scored multiple Grammy nods, including one for his 2012 debut album. Man, maybe I should change my name from Rumi. It sounds a little bit like the same word, but with a B. Next up, we have Justin Bieber, who got famous early, age 15. Gotta love the Biebs, am I right? I'm feeling the fever. How many boys got their hair like this after Bieber became big? When searching for videos of a different singer, Scooter Braun, a former marketing executive of So Def Recordings, clicked on one of Bieber's 2007 YouTube videos by accident. Impressed, Braun tracked down the theater Bieber was performing in, located Bieber's school, and finally contacted Millet. At 13, Bieber went to Atlanta, Georgia with Braun to record demo tapes. Bieber began singing for Usher 1 week later. That's fast. Bieber's first single, One Time, was released to radio while Bieber was still recording his debut album. The song reached number 12 on the Canadian Hot 100 during its first week of release in July 2009, and later peaked at number 17 on the Billboard Hot 100 chart in the United States. So yeah, sometimes a manager finding you is what it takes. Got famous late, Andrea Bocelli, age 41. So it seems like the opera type stuff, you can be a little bit older. My mom loves this. I think he's blind, right? Classic. It's very hard for me to listen to this without thinking about Marcelito Pomoy's cover that we talked about in this video. He did both the female and the male voice of this duet. But this is the original. This sounds amazing. Damn. They're holding hands. How romantic is that? This little sausage finger on top of her little sausage finger. Brings a tear to my eye. If there was someone else here, I'd put my sausage fingers on him. The Italian artist's voice is now recognized internationally, but Bocelli didn't get his big break until 1992 when a demo tape containing his rendition of the song Miserere. Yeah, that's it. Was sent to Italian tenor Luciano Pavarotti. Pavarotti was highly impressed by the young musician, and the duo recorded a duet, which became a smash hit throughout Europe. Bocelli was then signed to a record label in 1993 when he was in his mid-30s. He released his debut album, Il Mare Calmo della Sera, in 1994 at the age of 35, and his career took off. At the age of 41, his album Sacred Areas became the most successful classical album by a solo artist with over 5 million copies sold. Very cool. Okay, so Guts famous early, Michael Jackson, age 11. Who's Michael Jackson? I've never heard of him. Let's find out who it is. That's so dope. How high is that? The high note is like a high E flat. Oh, baby, give me one more chance. Age 11. That is crazy. Michael Jackson at age 11 was the youngest vocalist ever to top the Hot 100. As part of the Jackson 5, he topped the charts with I Want You Back on the week of January 31, 1970. With that achievement, he broke Stevie Wonder's previous record. For the late squad, we got Charles Bradley, who got famous at age 62. This I don't think I've heard this song before. So good though. I was about to say he sounds a little bit like James Brown, and now previous jobs, chef James Brown impersonator.
That makes sense.
It took 62 years for somebody to find me, but I thank God. Some people never get found, Charles Bradley told the US National Public Radio. At 14, he ran away from a chaotic childhood home, living on the streets for 2 years before an employment program called Job Corp helped him to train as a chef. It was a co-worker who told him he looked like James Brown, and even though he formed a band, traveling around the US playing small shows, success eluded him. In the 90s, he moved back to Brooklyn to reconcile with his mom while making a living as a James Brown tribute act called Black Velvet. Finally, he was discovered by Gabriel Roth, co-founder of Daptone Records, who made Charles Bradley a breaking artist at the age of 62. Oh, baby, gotta make it right. Oh yeah, man, he is getting good plays on these songs. That's so cool. It's not too late, guys. Not too late for anyone. Okay, guys, KK for more music reactions and reviews, KK for music VS videos, and I will see you tomorrow in another daily video. Good to know that you can be as old as you want and still make it as long as you watch every daily Roomie video. That is the only way to do it, though. See you tomorrow in another daily video. I will play you out.